This video has been sponsored by Surfshark. Hi everyone, James Mansfield here, bringing you yet another video. Oh my God, you guys. So it has been a trying time during this quarantine, okay? Things are getting scarce, and I have a feeling things are only gonna get worse. So I'm gonna prepare you folks. That's right. This is like apocalyptic preparation. Apoca prep. There you go. Patent that. James Mansfield. New word. Apoca prep.
Good day, everyone. I am Professor McDougal McGraw-Hill, keeper of facts on the internet. I am here to tell you, let it be known that on this day, James Mansfield invented the word apoca prep. Preparation for the apocalypse. That is all. Good day.
Yes. Oh my gosh. I wish I had a prep sponsorship right now. Anyways, kidding. I am going to show you guys how to make a wig. That's right. I am in dire need of a ponytail piece. So the best thing to use for those, in my opinion, are a hard front wig. And believe it or not, finding a 613 hard front is really, really hard right now. I scoured Amazon, eBay, everywhere. I can't get them unless they come from Australia or England. Are they the only people that wear falls anymore? God. Anyways, I'm gonna teach you how to make a hard front wig using a sewing machine and a weaving cap. Yes, I got this from Sally's, about $3. And I also used about 5 packs of bundled hair. This is 613 synthetic hair. Now, stay tuned and I'm gonna show you folks how to make a hard front wig. But before we do, this video is sponsored by Surfshark. Surfshark offers instant security, keeping your unmentionables private.
Not to mention, it blocks ad trackers and malicious websites.
Though it doesn't say anything about sending malicious hardware, so Trixie Mattel, you're safe for now. You can even stay safe on public Wi-Fi, and as a gal on the go, or former gal on the go, it's very, very useful in keeping my information private and locked tight. And all I know is my information is safe because sweetie, Surfshark has my back. Now, I probably shouldn't mention this part, but since we're such good friends, I'll tell you anyway.
You can change your internet location to access certain things like Netflix in different countries that you can't get anywhere else. Switch your location to Canada to watch Drag Race.
With Surfshark, you can access things like movies, TV shows, or sports if you're into that sort of thing, all from the comfort of your own home. It's sort of like having a region-free VCR, only you don't have to be a total geek to figure out how to set it up. And Surfshark is the only VPN service to offer unlimited access to multiple devices. Come on now. Use my code JamesMansfield to get 85% off, plus 3 extra months for free.
Link in the description.
And on top of that, Surfshark has a 30-day money-back guarantee. So what have you got to lose? Try it today.
Okay, let's get started. I'm going to be using a deluxe multi-use weaving cap, and I'm going to take that out of its packaging. Duh. Now, this next part is optional, but I'm using a silver Sharpie, and I'm going to create some guidelines on the outside of the weaving cap. I didn't realize this Sharpie was starting to dull, but they still read on camera. Now I'm gonna trace lines all upwards on the cap, and when I get to about the middle of it, I'm gonna take it and put it on top of a canvas wig block, or you can use like a foam wig head, something where you have more of a head structure, so you can get a more precise measurement of where you want your tracks to lay. We are creating a blueprint after all. Once those are all drawn on, we are going to start sewing. Now you can do 2 types of stitches for this. You could use a straight stretch stitch if your sewing machine allows that, or use the zigzag stitch so you have more stretch. And your tension should be about a 3 or a 4. I do about a 4 because it makes the tracks easier to remove because I like to switch out the colors from time to time. One thing you don't want to do is rush this. If you rush it, you're more than likely to make a mistake. Go slow on your sewing machine. And if you really want it to be precise and gorgeous, I highly recommend doing a hand stitch on this and not a sewing machine. I just did a sewing machine because girl, I'm in a rush and I don't got time to be doing all that with the hands. The construction of this is very, very simple. If you can thread a sewing machine, you can make a wig. If you've ever made a dance costume, it's like sewing on fringe. This wig is gonna be used for a ponytail piece, so I'm not gonna go too crazy on the preciseness of where I'm laying my tracks because it's gonna be cut and curled into a fall. But if you're gonna make a functioning hard front wig, you wanna take your time with this and really make sure those tracks are laid on good and perfectly. And try not to overpack the hair, otherwise it's gonna make the wig really, really heavy on your head. Oh, ignore my sexy boy leg. Okay, try that on your wig head and see how it looks. If it aligns right, you're good. If it doesn't, take your seam ripper and remove that track and redo it.
and just try your hardest to make sure these tracks line up with the tracings you made. Don't go off course, because it'll really show on your final result. And you'll have a really weird bungee wig. Find what works for you and don't be wasteful with the pack hair you have. And you may be thinking, I don't need to learn how to make a wig. I'm just trying to make you prepared for when the apocalypse happens, because there are no hair shops in the apocalypse. I've seen Mad Max Fury Road. I'm not walking around bald. I'll be damned if I'm walking around bald. I want you prepared. If worse comes to wear, you're going to be making wigs out of string, yarn, grass, anything, girl. And really try not to stretch the cap too much. Otherwise, you'll get like that Stegosaurus effect with your tracks. And for the top of the head, you're cutting and laying your tracks in a pattern. So it's going in sort of like a circular pattern, like you're creating a rainbow. And when you get at the small top of the head where the crown is, you're going to break that pattern and start laying tracks straight across in the middle of the crown of the head. I have my tracks laying backwards so that it creates a fall effect at the back of the head. If you want bangs, you're just going to reverse the direction of the tracks that's facing forward on the crown of the head. That way the hair will lay forward on the face. And then you can cut the bangs to your own liking. And girl, I was not lying when I said it was impossible to find a 613 hard front wig that I can use for a fall. Most of the wig shops here are either not near me or have closed down due to the whole pandemic thing, girl. And online, it is a dead zone. Everything that I found either shipped out of the UK or Australia, and I was not trying to wait 3 weeks for something when I have all the materials here in my house to make it. And I don't know about you, but I think it's kind of fabulous to make your own wig. I mean, I say that now. Once I started doing this, I realized just how much I don't enjoy doing it. But if you need a specific wig for a specific look, like maybe do cosplay or something, this is a great alternative. And who knows, maybe you found a new calling. You'll have a whole menagerie of wigs that you've created yourself. You'll be like Myra Rose, a wig for every occasion. And if you're doing a traditional hard front, what I did here is I took one last track and I'm sewing it on the inner rim of the wig cap with a very thin stitch. It's sewed under so it can fold over and hide the seams that you did on the wig. But bear in mind, no matter what, a hard front is exactly what you're getting, girl, a hard front. It is not gonna look natural unless you do a lot of extra work like a rooted hairline or something, or even go the extra mile and ventilate your own lace front. But I ain't doing that today, okay? I don't love y'all that much. I don't got that much time on my hands. And as a special treat, I'm also throwing this in for free. I'm making a bang piece. I'm gonna take a piece of felt. This is all I really had. I just needed a sturdy piece of fabric. You want more of like a buckram or like a very strong lace fabric, or even create your own pad for this. But I'm gonna use felt for this because it's what I had around. You're gonna cut a triangular shape that rounds off the top. And we're gonna lay our tracks on the fat end of the triangle. And then just cut your tracks to the shape of the triangle until you have no more left. We're only gonna make a slight change in direction when we reach the top of the triangle. I prefer a zigzag stitch for when I'm doing bang pieces because it's easier to change up the directions and you get a little more mobility out of them. Now, when you get to the top of the bang piece, I do something a little different. I take my tracks and I double them up in the size of whatever the remaining space is, and I'm gonna sew those in the opposite direction. And that way, when you fold it down, since we use that loose zigzag stitch, you can bend it over and it won't have an obvious seam at the top, disguising all of your seams. Then we sew on a little clip, cut it and brush it, and you have a bang piece. I'm using a small blank hair extension clip. They sell these at Sally's. They're commonly used for making hair extensions, but they work perfect for making a clip and bang. You can use one or two. It's completely up to your own preference. And for the clip, I just use a basic sewing stitch. If you can't thread a needle and make a simple stitch, why are you even watching this video, girl? And just like that, we are done. Be right back. Welcome back. This is the final result, bang piece and all. And I have to say, this is probably not something I'd ever do again. If you can buy a hard front wig, by all means buy one, because this is always such a tedious process to do. And honestly, this bang piece is what's holding everything together right now. I'm gonna rip this right off and turn this into a ponytail after this video is done. And this thing is so damn long. Oh my God. It is tangling up in my armpits as we speak. But I have to say, this is a very fun project, and if worse comes to wear and you have to start making your own wigs because, you know, the world ends or something, now you have the tools to do so. I just hope you have access to Wi-Fi or just retain this in your memory bank. I'm sure it'll all come pretty easy to you. It's just sewing. Now, grooming can be an absolute drag, but thankfully I have Manscaped. Use my code Mansfield or James20 for 20% off your purchase plus free shipping. It's for your no-no bits. And if you want to look gorgeous like me, be sure and use Gerard Cosmetics. Use my code James to get 30% off your purchase on regular priced items. Go to Gerard Cosmetics today. And now I'd like to take a moment, a Venmo moment, where I thank everyone who's tipped me on Venmo.
I would like to thank Mike, Sean, and Elizabeth. Thank you all so much for the tips on Venmo. Now, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And until next time, bye.
Click here and watch me transform Tokyo Styles Week from Bellamy Hair. Or let's talk about queer cinema while trying out Kimchi Chic's Two Queens, One Desert. Come on, click it. You know you want to. If you don't click it, I'll... And then... And take your face and... And no one will ever find your body. So click it!